to the 2021 fifth grade promotion ceremony for Ms. Hyman's class. I'm Beth Wallingford. I'm the principal here at Crestwood. It feels very strange to be introducing myself to you in person for the first time at the end of the school year, but such is the year that we've had. So I am so pleased to be able to welcome you into the building, not only to celebrate this important milestone in your child's life, the transition from elementary to middle school, but also because it does feel like that small step back to normal. And I know this year has been anything but normal. So before we begin, I do want to take a moment to thank you all for the support, patience, and understanding that you have offered us throughout this crazy year. Before we begin, I also do need to go through a couple of safety items. It may seem obvious, but we have doors to the left and doors to the right that you can exit in the event of an emergency. We will be conducting the entire ceremony in the gym. At the end, we will be able to go outside to the loop, and you can use the signs that have been provided to take some pictures with your child, and at that point, we can do it unmasked. So we'll keep masks on inside, but once we go out at the end, you can get some nice pictures with masks taken off. And with that, I think we need to move on to what's most important, which is celebrating your children. Each fifth grade class has its own unique group of students that we will never forget. At this time, I'm going to ask Ms. Hyman to come to the podium to present fifth grade certificates, and she's also going to celebrate some of the accomplishments that each child has had this year. I'm going to ask that we hold applause until the end, because as Ms. Hyman shares a few words about each student, we want to make sure that everyone gets a chance to hear. Okay, Ms. Hyman.
Good morning. Thank you so much for coming to show your support for one of my most special classes. As we all know, this year has been unlike any other. With that being said, our class has been together a lot due to the quarantine. Because of that, we have all grown very close. New friendships have been made, and a lot of laughs have been shared. We all know each other very well, from streaming from each other's living rooms to spending our day in our classroom. We have many fond memories through it all. We are like a family. The students bring out the best in each other, cheer each other on, sometimes argue, and support each other in their academics. As I call each student for their certificate, I'm going to share a few words about each of them and how they make our class family so special. Atiya Akami. Atiya brings joy to everyone she is with. She has an energy about her that is so special and unique. If you spend just a few minutes with Atiya, you will leave with a smile on your face. Atiya is a part of our family. Haley Anderson. Haley is considerate of everyone. She is always thinking of others. Haley is a mathematician and loves a challenge. She also takes the time to help others around her when they are stuck. Haley is a part of our family. Griffin B. Griffin is kind. Griffin includes everyone and has strong leadership qualities. He always has insightful things to say in a discussion and is very well spoken. Griffin has a heart of gold. Griffin is a part of our family. Luis Campos Becerra. Luis is thoughtful. He's always helping a classmate with the next thing to do if they were out without being asked. Luis loves learning about new topics in math and takes his time with every step until he has it. Luis is a part of our family. Crystal Cantonero Hernandez. Crystal is quiet at first, but once you get to know her, she has a lot to say. Crystal did not think that she would take to fractions or long division. Well, she mastered both. Now every day in math, she has a smile on her face and is ready for a challenge. Crystal is a part of our family. Manuel Hermona Suarez. Manuel is ambitious. Manuel is eager to learn and gives 100% with everything he does in school. Manuel is a strong mathematician, but also an amazing writer. Manuel never gives up and overcomes every challenge. Manuel is a part of our family. Paloma Carreto Pomona. Paloma is loving. Paloma has such a fun-loving spirit. She takes her time and puts her heart into all of her work. If something is challenging at first, she always perseveres. Paloma is part of our family. Hillary Constancia Hernandez. Hillary is hardworking. Hillary gives it her all in math, reading, and writing, and it shows. Not only is Hillary a hard worker, but she's always willing to help me in the classroom with any job. Her dedication and hard work ethic amaze me every day. Hillary is a part of our family. Carlos Dominguez. Carlos is cheerful. Carlos is also a dance machine, and when reading or solving math problems, he still has the rhythm. Carlos has grown so much as a reader and mathematician. I love being around Carlos with his positive attitude and continued growth. I can't wait to see him continue to blossom. Carlos is a part of our family. Alexander Gonzalez Garcia. Alex is focused. Alex is amazing at math and continues to master every new topic. This year, Alex has grown into an amazing writer using various strategies to convince his reader. Alex is a part of our family. Colton Hall. Colton is attentive. Colton is a mathematician, but this year has grown into an amazing writer as well. He's an independent learner and will continue to improve his writing every time he visits it. He's also very caring to every classmate and myself, offering to help or sharing a kind word or compliment to lift them up. Colton is a part of our family. Peyton Carvedon. Peyton is energetic. Peyton has the best sense of humor and has us laughing every morning with stories of her dog. Peyton is also an amazing friend to everyone in the classroom. She knows no stranger and is truly just a best friend. Peyton is a part of our family. Nolan Jett. Nolan is curious. Nolan is always asking questions and looking for answers. Nolan is very articulate with what he wants to say. He is a pro at our class debates, whether it's about plastic bottles or characters in the book Home of the Brave. He's well-spoken and able to gather his thoughts. He also makes us laugh with all his jokes. Nolan is a part of our family. Colton Leslie. Colton is kind-hearted. Colton is kind and makes everyone feel special. He gave his Shark Tank pitch his all, and he's learned to use his leadership skills to positively impact our classroom. Colton is a part of our family. Cora Lloyd. Cora is determined. Cora gives her best effort in math, reading, and writing. Her determination will help her succeed in whatever she wants to do. She's also our very own animal expert and teaches us about different animals, especially chickens. Cora is a part of our family. Honesty McCollum. Honesty is enthusiastic. Honesty has a passion for learning, and her enthusiasm is contagious. She's always ready to go for our ICANN statements. In our book club, she would be the first one to lead discussion with a smile on her face and has many insightful things to say. Honesty is a part of our family. Jonah Meacham. Jonah is inquisitive. He has a passion for learning that's unmatched. He's a brilliant mathematician and a very creative thinker. Jonah has insightful comments about various topics and books in our class. He always is asking deep questions, but he also has a caring heart. I can't wait to see what his talents will do for this world. Jonah is a part of our family. Riley Minyard. Riley is friendly. Riley can hold a meaningful conversation with anyone in the class. She's kind to everyone and takes the time to talk to them. She's a creative writer and also has grown into a strong mathematician. Riley is a part of our family. Salomon Dawisawa. Salomon is eager. Salomon is like a sponge, learning math reading at a rapid rate. He became a pro at fractions. Not only is Salomon a quick learner, but he's charismatic. He is, always has a big smile on his face and finds joy and laughter in the day-to-day. Salomon is a part of our family. Antonella Perez de Leon. Antonella is sweet and observant. Antonella is one of the first people to notice anything in the world around her. She also has a very sweet soul. Antonella is a part of our family. Brandon Riggins. Brandon is compassionate. He is very caring and is a true friend to everyone in the class. Brandon also has a witty sense of humor that adds a lot of fun to our classroom. Brandon is a part of our family. Ben Santos. Ben is enthusiastic. Ben's enthusiasm is contagious around the room. He's an amazing writer with the ability to effectively communicate with a variety of audiences. In fact, during NTI, when I was kicked out, he led our morning meeting beautifully. Ben is a part of our family. Arden Stess. Arden is creative. Arden is a creative thinker and always thinking outside the box. He always has a positive attitude and he loves social studies. Arden is a part of our family. Maggie Walker. Maggie is creative. She's able to articulate her thoughts and writing in an amazing way. Her writing piece on the humanity of zoos could convince just about anyone. This year, Maggie has also grown into a strong mathematician. Maggie is a part of our family. Thank you so much for sharing your wonderful students with me.
Okay, parents, so now I would like to present to you Crestwood Elementary 5th grade class of 2021. Let's give them a hand. Okay, so at this time in our award ceremony, we give two special awards. This is a Crestwood tradition that each year the principal chooses an award to be given out to a student who demonstrates academic excellence and strong leadership skills. The counselor will also be selecting a student to receive an award for strong character, so kindness, helpfulness, social emotional learning. So we're going to start with the principal's award. This year, our school theme was Bloom Where You Are Planted because we knew that we were going to find ourselves in some really unexpected situations, and we were going to have to do the best we could with whatever situation we found ourselves in. So the principal's award this year goes to a student who really exemplified that theme. This student was the epitome of the perseverance needed to keep going when times got tough, and also the resilience needed to bounce back when things didn't go her way. I can't think of better qualities for our future leaders and learners to possess than perseverance and resilience. She also grew as a learner tremendously this year. So I am pleased to present this year's Principal Award to Hillary Castaneda Hernandez. And now Ms. Wise is here for the counselor's award.
Good morning, everybody. It is always such an honor to be able to present this award to a student who is always such a kind friend, who is always willing to help, always showing integrity, and just making the classroom an all-around even more wonderful place. So it is my pleasure to give this year's counselor's award to Mr. Griffin B.
And so I'm going to ask the students to move to the floor so that they can see as well as we drop the screen. And as they're transitioning, there are some thank yous that I want to make sure are said because we have had a lot of help in putting together this end of year ceremony. So I want to thank the fifth grade teaching team, the school leadership team, including our assistant principal, Ms. Givens, our library media specialist, Ms. Bean, our literacy coach, Mandy Morris, and our counselor, Ms. Wise. Between those two groups, we really did the bulk of the planning of the ceremony. Ms. Sherry and her custodial crew for helping us set up and also transition quickly back to lunch. And also to our amazing PTA, especially the fifth grade rep, Mrs. McGraw, for organizing such a wonderful fifth grade celebration. I also want to thank our community partners. Out of the Blue provided the balloon arch and the balloon decorations. Reardon allowed us to borrow some flower arrangements. And the Sign Mama provided the signs outside. So I want to give a big thank you to those sponsors. So at this time, we have a short video presentation to share some of our students' lessons learned this year and their hopes for the future. Enjoy.
Thank you. assignment, and the lesson that I learned this last year is to make the most out of each and every moment. Thinking back to March 13th, I never would have thought that we would have been shut down for quite some time. So I've learned that no matter what is going on, to make the most out of each moment, because you never know when it's going to change or when it'll be your last. My hope for the future for my students is that no matter what they're faced with, that they always choose to be kind, always take the higher road and include others, and just no matter what, be kind. I'm going to miss my crew so much, but I know that they're going to do great things in middle school.
Okay, so as we wrap up our ceremony, I think there are a couple of other thank yous that we need to make sure are put out into the room. And first and foremost, I do want to say a very special word of gratitude to Ms. Hyman. She has loved your children well this year and held them to high, high standards. I don't know if you know this, but she was a first grade teacher previously. And so that move from first to fifth is quite a jump. And she has been amazing in making that transition. I'm just so proud of her. Sorry. And then I also want to thank parents, I also want to thank you beyond just the grace that you have shown us this year and your patience and understanding. I want to thank you for raising such amazing human beings here. This group of kids is kind and helpful. Not only have they learned a lot academically, but they have really grown as a classroom community, and a lot of that is attributed to the work you all have done as parents, and so I want to say thank you. We appreciate it. We cannot do this without you. So kids, give your hand. And now before we leave, a quick word of, I guess, advice, if you want to call it that, before we send you off to middle school. I feel like we have to, like, talk about this for a minute. Because I'm going to say, kids, you all are ready. I could see that through the lessons you learned this year and the hopes and dreams that you've shared. What I know as a former middle school teacher and as a parent who's had a couple kids going through middle school is where you become, start to become the people you're going to grow into as adults, right? And in middle school, you're going to have so many opportunities to get involved in art and music and different academic activities, sports. My advice to you all is to find your thing, right? Get in there, find something cool that you're interested in, something that makes your heart sing and that will help you reach those hopes and dreams you wrote about in that video, okay? Now, a word for parents in that transition to middle school, because I've done it twice now. I know some of you have been there, but for those of you who haven't, kids, I need you to look at your parents right now, look them in the eye, make some eye contact, and repeat after me. I'm not a little kid anymore. Now, parents, I want you to look right back, and it's your turn to say, but you're not yet grown up.
But you know.
Yeah, I want to hear it. But you're not yet grown up. Okay, so I think it's really easy in this transition to adolescence when kids start to have friend groups that become most important. It seems like they may not need you as much as they once did. They need you as much as they ever did, if not more. They just need you in different ways. So don't be afraid to continue to support them, offer guidance, knock on that bedroom door when it's closed for too long. You're just as important a part of their life as you were when they were little. And so, I wish you all the best in this transition to middle school. We have some fun things planned for you this afternoon and tomorrow, and we are going to give you guys a chance to get together outside. Not tomorrow, Monday. I'm like skipping over weekends. That is not what we need to be doing right now. So today and Monday, now I just lost my train of thought. Here we go. Okay, so let's talk about the logistics. So I wish you well in middle school. You guys are ready. You're going to do amazing. Okay? Here's what we're doing now. So you're going to get together.